Now, following the resignation of Matt Hancock, the Secretary of State for Health, we now go live to the Horticultural Society rhubarb competition.
You all have enough prizes?
This is my rhubarb.
And in just in a few words, can you tell me why you love rhubarb?
Doesn't everybody love rhubarb?
Well, it could be a little bit like wine light. You love it or you hate it.
No, and I have to. I look after my rhubarb. I stroke it every day.
And what a lovely, lovely rhubarb it is, too.
Thank you.
Surely must be a winner.
Thank you.
Oh, good morning, Mrs. Blummy.
Oh, good morning.
And you're from Blummingham.
Yes.
Very, very good.
And I'm going to win this year.
I think you have a fair chance of doing something.
Oh, thank you.
Winning, losing, it's all taking part.
Oh, yes, it is fun. Great fun.
Very nice bunch of rhubarb you have.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
Somebody sabotaged me.
Oh, Mr.
Can't Holmes. Have that.
This good morning.
Not, oh, I don't know who it is. Somebody. I mean, this is blooming good stuff, this is.
Oh, yeah. Is this a special species of
special species? It's a specially tough species that will survive under any circumstances.
Whoa.
Any circumstances whatsoever. It just, nothing can get it. Frost, shade, anything. It's perfect. It's best ever.
Will that leaf on the floor there grow back?
No. Those are the bait. If you sacrifice a few leaves, the rest are perfect. Oh. Always make a sacrifice. That's the sacrifice.
I understand, sir.
You're perfect.
Get rid of two or three dust leaves, chuck them out.
You make sacrifices in your country.
And only the healthy ones survive.
That's it, exactly. That's exactly
what. The Lord of the Jungle.
It's Darwin at its best. This is really good. And you can see it's very special because it collects things. It collects water and it runs down to the stems and the roots. It's a perfect design. I spent years developing this. It's going to be a worldwide success. I have got to win. I am not going to be sabotaged.
I wish you all the very best of luck, Mr. Glump.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Think you might win this show.
And pigs might fly.
Ah, you can rely on me, Mr. Glump.
No, oh,
no,
no,
no, no.
What?
Are you sure?
Good. Thank you very much.
Very good effort, Miss Vedelweiss.
Better luck next time. No. Blue. Second?
Very good effort, Miss Bloom.
Very good luck next time.
Very good.
I don't believe it.
Yes. Very well deserved winner.
But
congratulations, Mr. Glump. First prize. It's all in preparation.
We now come to the event we've all been waiting for, the judging of the final three exhibitors in the Great Hathaway Rhubarb Competition. Please give a warm welcome to our two judges, Mr. Percy Grower from the UK and all the way from Nanjing in China, our special guest judge, Mr. P. King. Help me, Doc.
Why does everything have to be turned into a competition?
Recount,
dude.
The winner takes it all. The loser has to fall.
It's simple and it's plain. Following from the Horticultural Society's rhubarb growers competition, there has been some serious allegations made about institutional corruption at the Horticultural Society. We now go live to the inquiry that is investigating these allegations.
I'd like to call this inquiry to order. Present are Mr. P. King, help me, Doc, from Nanjing in China. And then we have Mr. Glitch from the Hathaway Residents Association and myself, Miss Catchamos, taking notes. Again, from the Hathaway Residents Association, will be Miss Watts, our secretary. Right, shall we begin? Could you please tell this committee, have you had any connection to any of the people who were in that competition?
I have never had any relations with that man, ever.
Noted here. You were seen shaking hands with the winner of this competition. What do you have to say about that?
This is a traditional Chinese handshake from Nanjing, from very respectable people.
I wonder if the aforesaid person knows that.
The aforesaid person was more than happy to shake my hand in any form whatsoever.
Well, the Hathaway residents in general are not really happy with the way these competitions are run and have suggested that the rules should be changed. What do you think about that?
The rules have been in place, tried and tested for many, many years. No change needed. In China, this is perfectly normal. Nothing wrong here.
Well, shall we have a show of hands for those who think that they should be changed? At the end of the day, what you are saying is it comes down to
personal choice. Not at all. We are represented by a highly qualified body of people, respected throughout the world for our respective nations.
We've never heard of them.
Well, my sir, I would suggest that you listen more carefully.
But no one has ever heard of them. They've never done any growing. They're nothing to do with our horticultural world.
These people are experts in their field. They have gone to universities and they have studied and got degrees.
But their
they don't need to grow anything.
But their field is very, very limited. It is one paddy field.
No, sir. Their field is as large as their minds, as big as the universe.
A pea comes to mind, sir.
I think we need to call this meeting to a close. I think it is getting a little bit heated. I don't think that we've actually got anywhere. Do you, Miss Watts? Thank you, Mr. P. King.
It's been an honour. Thank you.
The results of the inquiry found that there was no institutional corruption and therefore the rules will remain the same.
Well, that was a right pickle.
It was.
Yeah.